There are many different ways to transform layers in Photoshop. However, some of them are a bit more flexible than others. When I open this file and I'm working on the background layer, if I want to make a transformation and I choose Edit, we'll notice that both Free Transform and Transform are grayed out. While I could choose Select All, and then select Transform, and then maybe Scale, if I transform this, Photoshop is going to fill this background area with my background color, in this case, white. So I'll click Cancel to cancel out of that transformation. Use Command-D to deselect. To convert the background into a layer, I'll click on the lock icon. Then I can choose Edit, Transform, and then Scale. However, if I scale the image now and I apply this transformation, Photoshop is going to discard all of the information. So if I wanted to scale it up later, it would have to make up information. So again, I'll cancel out of this. And then I'm going to convert my layer to a smart object by choosing Layer, Smart Objects, Convert to Smart Object. Or on the Layers panel, I could right-click and just choose Convert to Smart Object. I want to create a picture in a picture, so I'll duplicate the smart object using Layer, New, and then Layer via Copy, or using the keyboard shortcut Command-J on Mac or Control-J on Windows. I'll hide the visibility of Layer 0 and keep Layer 1 as the active or targeted layer. Now let's take a look at all of the different free transform options. I'll choose Edit, Transform, and we'll start with Scale. I can drag any of the corner points in order to scale, which will transform my image while maintaining proportions. If I want to transform freely, I can add the Shift key and drag any of the anchor points. You'll notice that as I'm dragging, we see a HUD or a heads-up display that gives me the width and height in whatever units of measurements I have selected for my rulers. You can turn this off under Preferences, Tools, Show Transformations. You can choose a different position or choose to never show the heads-up display, but I'm going to leave it on for now. If I want to transform from the center of the image, I'll hold down the Option key on Mac or the Alt key on Windows, and then drag, and we can see that it's getting larger or smaller based on the center of the image. If I want to access a different transformation, we can select it under the Edit menu, Transform, and then choose one from the list. I'll select Rotate, position my cursor outside of the bounding box. I'll see the double-headed arrows, and I can click and drag in order to rotate. If you position your cursor too far away, you'll notice that the icon changes to the arrow. If I were to click right now, Photoshop would automatically apply this transformation, so just be a little careful when you're doing things like rotate. If I ever want to remove the angle that I've rotated, I can simply select it in the options bar, tap 0 in order to remove it. By default, Photoshop is transforming around the center of the image because that's where the default reference point is. Now, I have my reference point turned on because I've got this option checked right here, but by default, the reference point is off. However, it's still in the center, so it would transform around that. To enable the reference point and make it visible, we can click here to enable it, and we can choose a different reference point, either by clicking on any of the anchor points here in the options bar, or I can drag the reference point by just moving it in the image area, or I can hold down the Option key or the Alt key and click in order to set a different reference point. Now you'll notice if I rotate the image, it doesn't rotate around the center, it rotates around that reference point. In order to set it back in the center, I'll click in the center icon in the options bar. To reposition a layer, we can drag anywhere inside of the transformation bounding box and just reposition it. Now I can continue to return to the Edit menu and then choose additional options here, but it might be easier to just right-click anywhere within the transformation area and select the different transformation that you want. If I choose Skew, I'll select one of the center anchor points and drag left or right to skew the image. If I want to change the perspective, I'll select it and then drag one of the corner points. And if I want to freely distort any of the anchor points, I can choose Distort and then select one of the corner points in order to distort my image. We can also use that right-click or the context-sensitive menus to rotate as well as flip our images. All right, I've made sort of a mess, so I'm going to tap the Escape key to escape out of here. And we're going to apply a simple transformation just to make the photo smaller within the document. Instead of choosing Edit and then Transform, I can just use the keyboard shortcut Command-T or Control-T to access Free Transform. I'll hold down the Option or the Alt key and just scale this down a bit. I'll tap Return or Enter in order to apply that transformation, and we can see the checkerboard representing transparency around this image. I'm going to turn that off by selecting Preferences and then Transparency and Gamut. On Windows, it would be under Edit, Preferences, and then Transparency and Gamut, and I'm going to set the grid size to none. I'll click OK, and now this area is still transparent, but it's going to be represented by white. I'll toggle on the visibility of layer 0, select it, and then use the opacity slider in order to decrease the opacity of that layer. Then, to get some separation between the two layers, I'll select layer 0 copy, and from the bottom of the layers panel, click the effects icon, select drop shadow. I'll make the drop shadow a little bit more opaque, and then to change both the angle as well as the distance, I'll just click in the image area and drag to reposition the drop shadow. To soften the edge, I'll increase the size. Then I'll click OK in order to add that drop shadow. A few additional options I want to mention before we wrap up. If you want to scale or rotate numerically, once you select Free Transform, in this case I'll use Command-T, you'll notice that we can add values for position as well as scale and angle in the options bar. And after transforming an image, you can use the Edit menu to select Transform and transform again. In fact, if you hold down the Option key or the Alt key on Windows, Photoshop will make a duplicate at the same time as applying the same transformation. And although we were using a photograph in this example, you can use the same transformation techniques when working on any type of layers, including shape layers, type layers, and more.